Hi everyone. Today I'd like to show you how to use some features that I'm introducing in the 0.5 preview of Mouseless. One is multicolor backgrounds, which can reduce your reliance on text in the overlay. And the other is modifier clicks, you know, like shift click to select a group of files or control or command click to add to selection. This feature is already present on Mac and some of the Linux versions, but it's new to Windows in this release. So for multi-background colors, you'll notice these new presets at the bottom here. And the RGB position-based one is designed to go with the position-based 16:9 grid preset, as indicated in the tooltip there. And that one has the left-hand keys at the top, and the right-hand keys on the bottom. And so with this preset, our background settings are set up to align with that, with the top row for each hand in red, the middle row in green, the bottom row in blue. This helps your brain create a quick association. So if you see that your target is in this top red area, you instantly know the first key is going to be in the quirt row. And if we change the color block size, you'll see that it no longer aligns with the rows. In a lot of cases, you're going to want to make sure this setting matches the number of level one columns that you have. And if we set it to zero, it distributes the colors evenly throughout the grid. So in this case, we have 30 cells and three colors, and that gives us 10 for red, 10 for green, and 10 for blue. Now, a lot of people like the position-based columns grid preset. It's a bit less dense with text and has an easy-to-understand column-row coordinate system. And with this kind of setup, you can use the rainbow columns preset, which maps the same column on each hand to a specific color. So we have red for our pinkies, orange for our ring fingers, and so on. And this is achieved with color transforms, which allow you to create variations within each color block. So in this case, we have one color block that's 10 cells wide, and we have 10 transforms, one for each column. So our first transform has no modifications, so we get the base red color here. Then at each stage, we add a little bit to the hue, which is this first number here. Then once we hit the middle, we start going back down towards zero to mirror the colors. One cool effect of using transforms to define the palette like this is that if we change the single background color, we can quickly rotate the hues of all the transform colors, or we can change the saturation or the brightness. Now, some of you might be wondering, what if we want to create distinctions within each top-level cell, which in this case is each one of these columns? That's where level 2 transforms come in. So let's add one. Let's lock our overlay so we don't trigger any hotkeys while we're editing. And let's change the hue a little bit. Use the up and down arrow keys to adjust the saturation and the lightness. And now you can see we've created two distinct regions within each column. And if we add a few more, and set up an alternating pattern, now within each column, we have one region for each keyboard row for the level two characters. So let's say this is our target. It's in the yellow column, so we know it's D. And it's in the fourth region, which corresponds to the right hand, middle row. And it's the second key from the end, so it's our ring finger. With practice, you might get to a point where you no longer need the first character or any text at all. This can be controlled with the care display setting. So right now it's all, so we have both characters in each cell. We choose second, the first character disappears, the one that tells you which column. And if you get really good, you can do no text at all. And if you make sure the subgrid text opacity is zero, even the subgrid has no text. This means a nice, clean, minimal overlay, pure muscle memory, no more reading text. To help you practice, I'll be making a training tool on the Mouseless website. I'm going to try to have something basic out within the next week or so. Now, just to help solidify these concepts, let's take a quick look at the other position-based presets. We've seen the RGB position-based preset. And if we choose position-based split or no text, we can see we have 5 level 1 transforms creating variation across the columns. And we have a level 2 transform creating a vertical split within each cell. So that's multicolor backgrounds in a nutshell. Now let's take a look at modifier clicks. These can be done in both overlay and free mode. The key here is to first make sure you don't have a given modifier assigned to any hold for commands within that mode's key bindings. So if we ensure we aren't using shift for the hold fors here in free mode, then we can do shift clicks by simply holding shift while we execute the mouse action. Same goes for command click or control click. Same goes for the overlay commands. We just ensure we're not using shift in these hold fors, and that means we can use shift clicks with the overlay. Just hold shift while you execute. Once this feature is battle tested in the preview release, I'll likely pull it into a v0.4 patch for those of you that prefer to stay on the stable release. And I'll be continuing to add features to make this all more friendly. For example, a read-only field that indicates which modifiers are currently available for modifier clicks, as well as standalone commands that execute a shift click or a control click, for example. Quick note on Linux, it is rather difficult for me to test every distro, but I found that modifier clicks work on Fedora 41 and partially work on Ubuntu 20, for example. If you want to report the status of this feature for your distro, that will help me in achieving wider compatibility. So that's the first v0.5 preview. Please like, subscribe, and share. And feedback on each release, whether on GitHub, Reddit, or via email, is always appreciated. Thanks for watching, everybody.